Now let's get into the organization of matter. To really understand how matter and what we as human beings know thus far of what exists in matter, we have to talk about the periodic table of the elements. One has to realize that every substance in the universe is made up of chemicals such as hydrogen, helium, oxygen. Thus, all the chemicals are made up of elements, whereas all the elements, again, are made up of atoms. You know, the building blocks of matter. So it could all be said that every substance, again, in the universe is made up not only of matter, but then the building blocks of matter, something we can pull out of matter that are atoms. Get it? So then what is the periodic table of elements? The periodic table of elements is the most important chemistry reference there is. It rearranges or arranges all the known elements in our world as we know it in an informative way. Elements or known pieces of matter are arranged from left to right, from top to bottom, by order of increasing atomic number. Nice to know that Russian scientist Dmitri Mendeleev was the one that actually organized this. But this guy was the 17th kid in a family that was from Siberia, so you can figure that he had a lot to do since it was freezing up there. But now it's nice to know that many people had something to do with the periodic table. And obviously, a prerequisite to the construction of the table was the discovery of individual elements. Now, even though we know elements such as silver, gold, tin, lead, mercury, copper have been known since antiquity, the first actual discovery of an element seems to have occurred in 1649 when Hennig Brand discovered phosphorus. Then during the next 200 years, elements continued to be added. The periodic table then, as you can see, from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all the way down here, is arranged by atomic number and then by similar properties.